Auto Krafters, your source for Cougar, Falcon, Fairlane, Full Size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford Truck. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
Okay, so your seat belts on your classic Ford truck. Now this is a bench seat seatbelt system from the guys at Retrobelt. We got ours through Auto Krafters. And frankly, if you're gonna do this on a bench seat vehicle, like a pickup truck, I always recommend you go ahead and get the third seat, which is the center seat belts as well. Just get yourself a set of standard lap belts for the truck. We'll be fine. You don't necessarily need retractors for that center section, but you can put them in there. We chose to just go without the retractables and just use a standard pull belt. But for the driver, we are doing a shoulder belt system in this truck. Now, if you're doing an F100 and you're doing an F100 built prior to 1971, you are not going to have the anchors in the B pillar like you do on the 71 and 72 trucks. And in 71, the mounting position for the seat belt was different at the beginning of the year than it was at the end of the year because Ford, he likes to change stuff. So when you're putting the seat belts in there, keep in mind that if you have an earlier truck, you're going to have to go into a lot more massage work in order to put these belts in there, but it can be done. You can actually get your hand up inside that B pillar a little bit, and we'll give you the position mounting for these when we go out and start working on where these things should be put in the vehicle. Basically, everything you need is on the table right here. You have an installation kit. That's this stuff back over here in the corner. And then this will allow you to install the seat belts on your truck. You'll need to get the installation kit because when you buy the belts by themselves, there is no installation kit to put it in with. You can, in some instances, use your original fasteners, but I found on the Ford trucks that the installation kit makes everything a lot easier, and we'll show you what we use on that when we put it inside the truck. One of the other things I'll say is this. The bolts that you have that come with the actual retractable belts are a little large for the bung that's actually in the B pillar. You'll need to go in and work on this and possibly even use one of the Ford hex head, Torx head, one of the Ford Torx head style bolts in order to put this in. Now this is a coarse thread, but this is more to the size of the actual hole in the B pillar, letting me know that probably what Ford used was this particular style with the shoulder on it like this has here. If you can't get this, you can make this particular bolt work. It's just a little tougher to make it work because it's really, really large. You need to use a much larger tap on it in order to get this to go in there. So with that, we'll be able to get rid of these original belts. Colors are a little bit different on it. I'm okay with that. This is more of a neutral gray tan color. This is an actual tan. This will actually tie very well to the interior on the truck that we're doing. Now, keep in mind of this too. You can order swatches from the guys at Retrobelt through the guys at Auto Krafters. Tell the Auto Krafters guys you need a set of swatches because you're not quite sure what belts to use. You get the swatches from them, and then you can know exactly what belt you want to put in your vehicle by laying them on the seats and the carpet to get a good idea on color. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to smoke outside and get the truck in and start working on this thing, show you guys how to install them. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and show you if you don't have a 72 Ford pickup truck at hand and you're working on one of these bump side trucks, what you need to do to find out where your seat belt needs to be. Now, normally on these trucks, on the 72 models, they put them in the B pillar. Some early 71s actually had them back by the rear window. Now we're at about 2.5 inches from the center of the hole to the outside lip of the B pillar line here. Normally there's a gasket here, but I've got them out on this truck. You'll also want to get another measurement, and your other measurement will come from the bottom of the B pillar to the center line, and that is 13.5. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna bore out the center of this for the belts that we got from Auto Krafters. What I'm gonna do first is, since we do have the bung here, is I'm gonna go in and drill this out. What I will tell you is this, if you're gonna be putting your seat belt in the position that I've told you about, I do recommend getting a seat belt installation kit with this whenever you put it in, so that it makes it a little easier on you trying to put all this stuff together. Welded in, it should be fine because you're gonna have the pull of this entire B pillar. If you're getting in that kind of an accident, you've already got a problem. Now, I put on my safety glasses because we're gonna be making shards with this. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a 10/32 drill bit to start this with because it's roughly the same size, and I'm gonna work my way up from there. Now I'm gonna go from there to a 13/32 drill bit. 13/32 drill bit is going to make it a little smaller hole then what you're gonna need to tap it out to for the actual bolt.
Yeah. New battery.
Figures it was always that last little bit. Now I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in and grab my tap and tap the hole out. I've already started this one and I'm about done with it. Use a 7/16 20 tap in order to tap this hole out for the bolt that goes in here. Sometimes a good idea to use a little cutting fluid on this too and make sure that you start it off straight. On the other side, I didn't do that. And it's a little harder to get the bolt to start up. This one, I went in pretty straight because I was able to use this tool to get it in there. The other bolt was actually further back inside this larger hole because, you know, 72, quality is job one. All right, gonna pull this back out, got it tapped. And this will allow us to mount our seat belt for preparation to finding our location on the bottom, and that's where we're headed next.
Into the bowels of the bottom of the seat area.
Tapped. And now what I've done here is I've gone in and I've mounted it up at the very top and I've taken and assembled my seat belt assembly the way I want it. In other words, I've got a spacer, which is one of the lock washers here, and a lock washer here holding this into position, making sure that the loop of this is not contacting the backside of our retractor here so that we're not rubbing this all the time when we're running it. Now I've got one of the L pieces from the install kit. And what I want to do on this is I want to have the longer end of the L on the actual retractor and the short end on the floor of the truck. That seems to be what works best on the F100. And what I'm going to do is pull this into position. And what you're trying to do is with the seat all the way back, when it's forward, it's not as big an issue, but when the seat's all the way back, you want to be sure that you have enough room for this retractor assembly to have the space it needs so that the retractor itself will pull freely inside the truck. You have a little room on the F100. You can go out to about right here on this lip and you're not going to contact the door, but you do want some what I call rattle space all around the retractor. You don't want it contacting the gas tank. You don't want it actually contacting the B pillar here. You want it to have a plenty of room, and that's, you know, anywhere from a 16th to an 1/8 of an inch of room all the way around it. The nice thing about the retractors on the retro belts is there's plenty of space. You can knock this in a little bit, so to speak, where you push it back and it sits out a little bit onto that lip. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to mark my position with this auto rider pin. These are really nice for going in and actually doing this kind of work. I'm gonna mark the outside perimeter about where I think it needs to sit with it in a locked position, like with it sitting flat on the floor in here. Really can't see this, but we're gonna mark it up, and that way we're gonna pull this out, and I'm gonna now go in and disassemble all of this. I'm gonna use this to mark my position off of this line here, so I've got a center point to drill to. I will tell you on the F100s, on the backside back here, there's a brace that runs right along in here, and you're gonna have to probably either drill down through the brace or cut the brace back in order to put a spacer back there behind it so that it, whenever you do, God forbid, have an accident, it doesn't pull the sheet metal up. It actually pulls on a bigger roundel that's in the floor here. That's something for another time, so to speak. All right, so I'm gonna take that apart and drill down through there and basically do the assembly so you can see the final assembly on this. And I'll talk about the big washers that come with the installation kit and why you need them and where they need to go when we get through with all that. Now, we've got this mounted in here, and what I'm gonna tell you right now is there's a brace that runs like right along the line of where I drilled my hole. Sometimes these things happen. What I would recommend doing is if you have the ability in the room, bringing this a little further over here, because what you'll wanna do is go on the back side of this, cut your washer down at the back, and then bend the front edge of the washer along here downward so that you can match this slope here on the inside floor pan. What I would then probably do if it were up to me is I would go in and weld the washer to this brace that's running back along here where the original seat belt sat. And I know what you're thinking, should we not have been able to get the seat belt to sit here? I tried several different ways with this particular bracket, which I really like this bracket from the guys at Retrobelt, and I couldn't really get it to where I was satisfied with the way it looked and worked, because it pushed us too far back. When you tried to set it sideways, the seat wouldn't work. So this is the best place for it right here. And you're going to have to ish it, and you're going to have to work with whatever seat you're working with. If you have a stock F100 seat in here, the position we've used here may not actually work, and you may have to do something else. But that's the beauty of these belts, is you can kind of go in and muck around with them and set them up exactly how you need them. All right, let's say your seatbelt clip is facing the wrong way. It's actually facing toward the outside of the truck. You want it facing toward the inside of the truck. The way you fix that is you take the belt and you do this. You pinch it down a little bit, and you can get it to start through and go all the way through, and then the direction of your belt is changed. Just a little tech tip for you.
All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to squeeze my big behind in here, and I'm going to talk to you a little bit about your center belts. Now, when you're doing the center seats on this, what you want to do is you want to grab a washer of some kind, put that down so that the belt piece is not sitting straight on the floor. I'm using a Ford factory style washer for this, and I'm also using my Ford factory fasteners when I'm going back in with this. When you do this and you're doing shoulder belts on the outside mount, you want to make sure that the center seat belt is on the bottom and that the shoulder belt, inner belt, is on the top. That being said, straight bolt in, you're good to go, and all that's left for us now to do is to go in and test this thing and see how we like the way it sits. If I can get my big butt out of here. Let's see what we got here.
I now have belts in my truck. I'm really happy about it. Retrobelt and the guys over at Auto Krafters really came through for us on this. Looks really good, except for the guy on the belt, because I feel like I probably need to lose a little weight looking down. But that's not your problem. Now, the belts look really good in here. And that's what we're going to do for the week. So do yourself a favor and come back and watch us next time on Manic Mechanic. And also check out our other show, Autorestomod. Both these shows air on this channel, Manic Mechanic every 2 weeks usually, and Autorestomod every week. So see you next time. I'm going to pack all this stuff up and go for a drive in my truck with the new belts on.